Eight officers have been sent to God for judgment as unknown gunmen took their gospel to Ahafia Police Division. Hear the news in details. Wonderful people of Biafra, lovers of freedom all over the world, you are welcome once again to Biafra Unite Channel / Television. This very wonderful moment. The information reaching us right now has it that eight officers, policemen, have accepted the gospel of unknown gunmen in Ahafia Police Division, happening in Abia State. Initially, it was confirmed that six people accepted the gospel at the spot, but after some few minutes, it has also been confirmed that two more people who sustained bullet injuries have also accepted the gospel, making the number eight police officers who are now on ascendancy for judgment. This is something that we all from Biafra must be happy about, unless you are a saboteur, unless you are evil, that you can never be happy about this. We don't care who is involved, because we have been warning our people to resign from anything serving the zoo. If you are serving the zoo, then count yourself in. When it happens to you, we will give the news the same way we are giving it right now, without any apology, without any cry, without any tears on our eyes. That is the gospel truth. So it's only a saboteur cannot enjoy to hear this kind of news, because there's a word in Igbo language, a saying that says, that is the gospel truth. Every day, the native doctor knows how to eat the one that a normal person bring for him in the shrine. Every day you bring goat, every day you bring chicken, every day you bring fowl, every day you must bring something. One day is good for a normal person to eat the one of that native doctor, because it's not an abomination. Yes, these people have been killing us for how many years? Dated back since 1966. They massacred us, they murdered 3.5 million able-bodied men and women in 1966 to 1970. If you add the children who were starved by hunger, then you will be talking about 5 million people murdered in cold blood in Biafra land. Because of what? We want to be on our own. Is it by force to be in unison with the people from Futa Jalon, with the bloodsuckers who do not understand the meaning of life? We call it mado in Igbo language. Mado, that is the, it means mankendo, the beauty of life. That is the meaning. But these people do not understand what it means to be alive. They don't know it. Allah have promised them, if you kill people, if you kill people who are not Muslim, your own type of their own type of Muslim, you have 75 virgins to marry in heaven. That is what has been promised to them. In case you don't know, that is the reality. Whenever you hear this thing, don't think it's just a propaganda. It's the reality. That is their mentality. So how can you now be in one country with this type of people who have this kind of mentality, who want to kill you to be able to inherit 75 virgin in heaven? I think that is what they are thinking of. You know, when our people are talking about restructuring, you know, to make Nigeria better, how can you make Nigeria better when Fulani is at the top of the helm? They are on top of everything you are doing. Even if today that Fulani man is not the president of Nigeria, they are still in the one in charge. As long as Abuja remains in the north, Fulani is still in charge. As far as oil is concerned in Biafra land, Fulani must be in charge. The day you try to remove Fulani's hand from oil, that day will be war in Nigeria. That is the gospel truth. Count how many oil wells and oil block in Biafra, in the whole of Biafra land. Now tell me how many of them are being run by a Biafra man. They are all Fulani's. All of them from A to Z, Fulani, apart from Obasanjo. Have you seen the reason why when you talk about restructuring, they will look at you as you are a fool? So what you are talking about, what you are thinking, is not what they are thinking. You are dealing with people who are only thinking how to kill you and occupy your land to be able to inherit everything. And you are telling them about restructuring. You must be insane. You are such stupid because you cannot reason. So the best way is for us to fight it out and get what belongs to us. Because our freedom is something that we cannot joke with. Our freedom is sensitive. Our freedom is sacrosanct. We can't joke with it. Any other thing will come later. But our freedom first. And our freedom is in the hand of lion. So we have to open the mouth of lion and take it. It's possible, but we have to fight for it. We have to die for it. Before you can manage to open the mouth of lion to take what is in the mouth of lion, you must have had a lot of injury. You must have had a lot of injury, and lion might have killed some people who tried to take what is in his mouth, what he's eating. Have you seen it? That is the gospel truth. That is how it is. Our freedom. They are about to swallow it before we woke up. Our freedom is in the mouth of Fulani and Britain. They are about to swallow it before we woke up, before IPOB came on board. Now we have to open their mouth wide, chuck our hand inside and take it by force. If not, if you don't do that, my brothers and sisters, you will remain slave in Nigeria till eternity. Perpetuity, you cannot run away from it. Even if you like, travel abroad, go to America, stay there, live there, give back to all your children. When they will grow, they will answer the name of Americans, they will speak, even if you give them your own name, they will remain there forever. When you die, they will bring you back to Biafra land, and your name will be erased in this very world. Because they are not ready to come. Where do you want them to come? Where do you want your children to come? This kind of hot weather here, no cooling. We are dying in hot weather, and there's no cooling it. There's no way to cool it down. We don't have any good system. At least the children who were born and raised in America, who have seen life, who have seen how to enjoy life, who have enjoyed social amenity for all through their life. You want them to come and suffer in Nigeria? There's no way. There's no hope. You want that beautiful car you want them to drive in Biafra land? Where? Which road are they going to drive it? Which water are they going to drink? If mosquito bites them, which hospital are they going to go to treat themselves? These are the questions you must ask yourself. So if you don't give yourself a meaning now, forget about your generation. Forget about, and how do you give yourself a meaning? Is to join hands to fight for Biafra. Anything it will take. Even if it will take us to kill every police officer serving or army officer serving in Nigeria armed forces, we have to kill all of them before they will listen to us. We have to devise a means to wipe all of them, all. Anybody who is seen wearing police uniform of Nigeria or army uniform, navy uniform, as long as that very uniform is on your body, you are a target. So we have to devise a means, anywhere you see them, kill them. That is how it is. And anybody who speak against it, we have to go against that person. And we have to kill that person as well. Because let me tell you the reality. If Arjuna was killed by Ojukwu, you know, we don't teach our people these things. We don't teach them. If Arjuna was killed by Ojukwu, and he's an Igbo man. Yes, so he's a saboteur. That is the reason why, have you had anybody give birth to a child and name him or her Ifeajuna since 1970? Of course, it's not possible because we know what that name means in our midst. That is the same thing I told Nyesho Nwike. By the time we deal with him and we are going to erase his entire name from this very planet Earth, nobody will give birth again and give that child that name Nyesho Nwike. Nobody, because he's a big time saboteur in our midst, and we are going to deal with him mercilessly. So anyhow, we are going, you know, any kind of ruggedness, any kind of attitude, be it good or bad, that we know we can do to draw the world attention, to make Nigeria government to understand we are serious, we have to utilize it. We have to do everything humanly possible to get their attention, to know that we are serious on what we are doing. If we keep on agitating peacefully, carrying flag up and down, my brothers and sisters, we are doing nothing. Because the people we are dealing with, if you do not understand the meaning of Fulani, if you don't ask Hausa people question what they saw, the history, you will not understand what I'm talking about. If you have not seen anybody from Guinea to ask them about Futa Jalon, what happened in 18 something, You will not understand what I'm saying. If you don't ask anybody from Senegambia about Fulani, you will not understand what I'm saying. Until you make this research, then you come back now to say, so this is what we are talking about. Now you join hands to make sure we get our freedom. Because if we don't get Biafra, Holy Ghost fire. God forbid we are going to get Biafra, my people. And this is the time. Now is now or never. Everybody must rise up now to support what we are doing. Support ESN, support unknown gunmen, and pray for them. 8 police officers have already been sent to God for judgment, and we are happy about that. Thank you, my people. Share this news and make it go viral.